About 30 to 40% of people who have type 1 diabetes will have kidney disease, and about 20 to 30% of people with type 2 diabetes will have kidney disease. Now, not all of them will progress to kidney failure, meaning requiring dialysis or transplantation, which is everybody's biggest fear when they come see me, but some will, and it's very important to diagnose these people early and to treat them early. When you develop kidney disease and it worsens, not only do the kidney functions get worse, but almost every other aspect of diabetes gets worse. The kidney disease seems to be that tipping point when the cardiovascular system, eyes, and other issues all start worsening at a more rapid rate. So early diagnosis of kidney disease, early aggressive management actually has a huge effect on protecting the rest of your body from the side effects of diabetes. There are three main areas we approach to help slow progression of kidney disease. First area is blood sugar control. So we work closely with the Joslin diabetologists or any of the other physicians you might be working with to get the appropriate level of blood sugar control that will have a dramatic effect on slowing progression of any complication of diabetes. Number two is blood pressure control. It may be the most important aspect of protecting kidneys from damage is getting your blood pressure to as low as possible for you to make that makes sense that you don't have side effects from it, but also protects kidney function. That's a complicated procedure nowadays because it requires multiple medications. And at Joslin, we're very familiar with using all these medications to make them work properly and to limit the side effects from all of these. And number three is another aspect of kidney disease is development of protein in the urine. And if you have protein in the urine, that can lead to worsening kidney function. And the way we approach that is using particular medications in addition to the blood pressure and blood sugar control that target the urine protein control. And together, taking all these various approaches, as well as some others that may also slow progression of kidney disease, we're able to dramatically reduce the likelihood of you ending up on dialysis or transplant. We focus primarily on people with diabetes. 90% of our patients have diabetes and kidney disease. We're comprised of five nephrologists and one nurse practitioner whose combined experience adds up to over 100 years' worth of patient care. We have seen all the complications associated with diabetes and kidney disease. We have seen all the unusual diagnoses and other conditions. We know how the medications work in patients with diabetes. So we bring all this unique expertise to the situation, and we can best manage that because we've seen all this. Moreover, we work very closely with the adult diabetologists, with exercise physiologists, with nutritionists, as a group to provide you with the best education as well as the best care plan that you can have to take care of your kidneys. So there are no symptoms that you'll have that'll tell you that it's necessary to see a Joslin nephrologist. This can only be done by lab tests. When you develop symptoms from kidney problems, your kidney disease is very far gone, so you do not want to wait till that time period. So there's a blood test and there's a urine test that's primarily used. The blood test is called the serum creatinine, creatinine, and that is a reflection of your kidney function, and that test is then put into a formula called the GFR formula, and that gives you an assessment of where your kidney function is. And the other is the urine test, which is measures the amount of protein in the urine, and that, if elevated, is a sign of kidney damage. So if you have diabetes and you have a decreased GFR and/or increased urine protein, then you should see a kidney doctor.